Hello and welcome back to WC Marketplace. Today's video will be all about the subscription products. When you want to have products or services that can be periodically supplied and customers pays in advance for the arrangement and cancels at any point when needed, is this the time when you need to have a subscription products? Before proceeding further with the subscription products, we need to keep in mind that both the Advanced Frontend Manager and WooCommerce subscriptions need to be installed and activated. Now let's see how we can go about that. From the admin dashboard, navigate to WCMP and from there go to settings. Once redirected, then go to the capabilities tab and enable the simple subscription option under the product type to allow the vendor to upload a subscription products. Now let's have a look how the vendors can upload a simple products from their dashboard. Navigate to add product page under the product manager and then follow our patent way of adding the product which we have been following for long. As always, add a product title, description and upload the image for the particular subscription product. Now select subscription from the drop-down menu of the product type. Once done, you will notice that few fields are added under the general tab. In the general tab, set the subscription price that you will change every day, week, month or year after your customer has signed up for a plan. The expiry date after field allows you to end a subscription after a specific amount of time. Subscriptions for subscription products with a value in the field have a maximum length, after which they expire and are no longer active. When a subscription plan has a sign-up fee and no fee trial period, the very first payment is the total of the sign-up fee and the price per period. In simple terms, if a customer sign up for a plan for the first time, he will be charged with the sign-up fee. Free trial, as the name suggests, is the time you provide your customers for a demo of your product. Technically, an optional period of time to wait before charging the first recurring payment. Any sign-up fee will still be charged at the outset of the subscription. Sale price. You can also set the sale price for the subscription product and can also schedule it by clicking here. Enter the schedule date by clicking onto the calendar. The downloadable section in the general tab appears only if downloadable is checked. Here you can add your files that will be available after purchases. Downloaded limit and download expiry are also set here. Click on add file to add more files for download. As the rest of the tabs are all the same, I don't want to bore you again by giving the description of each tabs. But for our knowledge, the shipping tab can be an optional tab depending whether it is a digital or a virtual product or not. In this tab, you can configure the weight and dimension of the product as an entirely and set the shipping class for a product. Additionally, shipping for subscription product is normally charged on the initial order and all renewal orders enabling one-time shipping will charge shipping once on the initial order. Now let's switch to the variable subscription. Like we did for the simple subscription, check the box for variable subscription. Under capabilities tab to allow the vendors to upload a variable subscription products. Now switch to the same place to the vendor dashboard to know more about the variable subscription. After adding all the necessary details regarding the product such as title, description and image of the product, select variable from the drop-down menu of the product type. As all the tabs are already discussed in details in our previous videos, we'll jump straight to the tab which is important for our variable product. That is the attributes and the variation tab. Attributes define a product. You can either add a new attributes that was not previously created or you can choose from a predefined global list of attributes set by the admin. Let's have a look how one can manually add an attribute. Name the attributes, for example, size. Set values separated by a vertical pipe, for example, small, medium, and large. Enable the visible on the product page checkbox. Enable the user for variation checkbox. Click on plus icon to add more attributes in the same way as it was added in the previous step. For adding a preset attribute, select the attribute from the product attribute drop-down menu. Now click on add to add the preset attribute. Keep repeating the same steps in order to add more preset attributes. Now add the variation in the respective tab. For that, make sure after adding all the attributes, you have enabled the option use for variation. In the created variations, you can upload an image. If enable is checked, the variation will show on the front end. This setting is checked by default. The downloadable section appears only if downloadable is checked. Here you can add your files that will be available after purchases. Download limit and download expiry is to set here. Click on add files to add more files for download. Enable the virtual checkbox. If your product is a digital product or does not require shipping, this removes the shipping section from your variation. If manage stocks remain unchecked, only the stock statuses option is visible in the inventory tab and the single product page will only display the stock statuses if set out of stock. And you will be responsible for updating the stock statuses manually. However, if manage stock is enabled, the option will be visible here. Stock quantity. On updating the stock quantity, WooCommerce auto manages the inventory and auto updates the stock statuses as in stock, out of stock, or on back order. Allow back orders. Whether or not to allow back orders, that is order even after out of stock. You can add separate SKUs for each variation in the SKU field. When a subscription plan has a sign-up fee and no trial period, the very first payment is the total of the sign-up fee and the price per period. In simple terms, if a customer signs up for a plan for the first time, he will be charged with the sign-up fee only. Free trial, as the name suggests, is the time you provide your customers for a demo of the product. Technically, an optional period of time to wait before charging the first recurring payment. Any sign-up fee will still be charged at the outset of the subscription. Set the subscription price that you will charge every day, week, month, and year after your customer has signed up for a plan. The expire after fee allows you to end a subscription after a specific amount of time. Subscriptions for subscription products with a value in this field have a maximum length, after which they expire and are no longer active. You can also add a sale price and schedule the time for the sale. Lastly, you may add an optional description for each variation in the description box. So this was all about the whole subscription product. Take your time and try to configure them from your end. And do not forget to let us know what you feel. With this, we have come to the end of our video. If you like the tutorial, then do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Click on the small red bell to get notified whenever we post a new video. And do not forget to check out the description box below for more useful links. Thank you for watching.